Hey there. The stakes are high. The prize is anyone's. And there's just over 100 hours left to go in the house. There's only one show that's going to take you through to that final furlong. In fact, I go as far as to say you have tickets in the Royal Box. It's day 60. That would be July 22nd. And this, my friends, is Big Brother's Little Brother. Hello, hello, everybody. Welcome to Big Brother's Little Brother. I hope you're all very well. The reason I'm skipping is because I'm excited. It's our last week, which means holiday! No, just kidding. Which means a lot of excitement this week, but we kick off, as we always do, Little Brother's Big News. Indeed. And Alex lost sleep last night over the mystery illness of his favourite housemate. He would be Big Red. After less than 3 hours sleep, he rose at the crack of dawn just to check on his Big Red.
Red, eat.
That cockerel, did you see that cockerel jumping up and actually eating lettuce out of his hand? He has him tamed. Okay, we'll keep you updated on Big Red's progress as the show goes on, I'm sure. Secondly, paranoia has set in. Earlier, Kate and Johnny became convinced that someone were evicted tonight after they caught sight of staging behind the being erected outside the house. Take a look.
Have you taken it down or put it up?
I'm not putting it up, Johnny. Jade, one of us is staying tonight. One of us is staying tonight.
No,
Look outside.
Go and have a look outside. You see that on a Friday?
What?
The men on top of it?
Johnny!
Yeah.
Nice fart noise, Johnny. We can confirm, however, this is not the case. There'll be no eviction tonight. And finally, the housemates have been set a seaside special task. Each of them must learn a traditional variety act by tomorrow night. Here's just a glimpse of the preparations of Jade's star turn as a ventriloquist.
Hello, my name is
Bob.
And what does Bob want to do today? Oh, so what are you doing? What game would you like to play, Bob? I'd like to play a skipping game.
Skipping game?
Skipping game.
I want to do that.
The little cutie. We can go live to the house right now to see what I understand, unconfirmed, unsubstantiated reports of Kate plate spinning. There you can see. Very good. Very impressive. Reminds me very much of Larry Grayson a la Generation Game. Oh, no, that was a nice move. Very impressive. Wonderful there. Okay, more on that as it happens. That was Little Brother's Big News. So anyway, 1,414 hours to go. Oh, sorry, after the housemates enter the house, it's time to ask you, who do you think will win? And these are the usual numbers. Alrighty, over the last 9 weeks, Big Brother's attracted a host of celebrity fans. We're delighted to welcome another one. That one would be Nina Wadia. Oh, there was anger there, Nina, which almost took out my whole left side.
That's gotta hurt.
It does hurt, but you come desensitised to it after a while. Okay, so, we're down to the final four. Mm-hmm. Are you surprised by anyone who's made it to the end?
All of them.
Really?
Yes, seriously, incredibly surprised. Except perhaps maybe Alex.
Who would you have said, when watching, who would you say would make it instead of them?
I think Spencer would have definitely lost it. I mean, he had a huge kind of female fan base, as far as I know, and quite a few male fans as well. I actually thought Tim would get a bit further as well.
Right.
But
through watchability?
Yes. Yes, definitely. But, I mean, Jade is by far kind of the big favourite in terms of just animation. She has just so much to offer.
With that in mind, would you like to see Jade walk out with the 70 grand?
No.
Who do you want to win?
Alex.
You want Alex to win?
Yeah,
why Alex?
Well, I think it's because he's probably the most sane of the lot. And a walking fashion show for me, so it's just great.
When you say sane of the lot, we do have to put that in some kind of context.
Yes.
Just want to get before we go any further. Right. Now we're nearing the end. What for you has been the best moment or moments of the series so far?
There is a particular moment with Jade hyperventilating, which I thought was quite fascinating.
Very strong. We've teed out for you right now.
Oh, great.
Just coincidentally, it's in one of our video machines. Take a look at this.
No. Don't
think about it, Jade.
To think. I've got there. I've got to tell her everything about me. To think she can stop moving about like that is killing me, Alex.
Well, you might be killing me, but even little things like whose bed are you sleeping every night?
Don't sleep in my own bed there. That's my bed. This is my bed.
Jader.
Just the back left there, that was just one incident in the whole Veruca Gate scenario.
Yes, it was, yeah.
It's a night of pure entertainment for everyone outside the house. Right, some housemates head straight back to their normal lives when they come out of the house. Others seem to hang around quite a lot. Certainly a lot less this series, but in the first two series. Who do you think we'll be seeing more of? Who's going to do an Arinda on us?
Oh, goodness. I think it would probably be Kate.
Really?
Yeah, I think Kate would be the one that people would watch in terms of... I think she deserves her own sitcom when she comes out of this.
You do?
I think she does.
Okay.
I think she's a real kind of character. She's a ladette and she's sensitive and she's just everything all rolled into one.
Let's script that now.
Yeah, right?
Me and
should.
You can write it.
That's it.
Right. It's called Kate World.
Kate Gate.
Kate Gate. God, that's good, yeah. And she is what? What should we have her doing
I think
for a
she
living?
Should work in... she should be a vet.
Oh, I like
I think
this.
A vet would be nice.
Right.
And her assistant should be Jade.
Jade's
assistant.
I think
so.
Right, okay. Lovely. Yeah, let's go pitch it tomorrow. Okay, now, moving on to the question of Tim's hair, the sensitive issue of Tim's hair. Mm. Are you a fan of the current colour that you'd have seen on yesterday's Big Brother's Little Brother, or would you rather see its natural ginger shining through?
Well, I mean, a lot of people don't know this, Dermot, but actually I'm ginger. But
shut
I
down.
Just dye my hair black so I look Indian.
I like that.
Yeah,
I like that.
So I quite...
If I do that, will that work for me?
I think it would. I think you could go any shade, actually, but... What? No, I think ginger's a great look. I've had ginger boyfriends and they're very, very, very sweet.
Okay, well, this morning we sent him on a surprise trip to a top celebrity hair salon to find him a colour he liked. This is what went on.
Hiya, Tim here. Daniel Galvin in London. Come for a bit of a consultation on the so-called ginger wig. Get him to sort it out and hopefully give us a bit of a new look. So, go and say hello. Hi Daniel, Tim, nice to meet you.
How are you?
Yeah, good, thanks.
Good.
You're tall. Yeah, I know, you're tall apparently. Apparently you're gonna sort me out.
I
know what I was
waiting for. I mean, you're natural colour, what are they talking about? The ginger? There's no ginger there at all.
I know, I didn't think so.
Really thick, isn't it?
Oh, there's plenty of it.
But with those eyes, I mean, any sort of gingery tones, orange tones, yellow tones don't suit you.
No, sure.
I've really got to bring the lights up to more of a sort of very sort of creamy, milky tone.
Perfect, no, beautiful.
And that'd really be great for you.
Man, he looked like the robot at the end of Superman 3. Okay, so, do you want to know how it turned out?
Yeah, definitely.
Do you want to know how it turned out? Okay, well, here he is now, Tim Cully, with his all-new hairdo.
Oh, my goodness.
Ooh la la, c'est la
hello, 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 yeah, nice to meet you.
Voulez-vous coucher avec moi, c'est soir.
Later, later.
What do you think?
I love it. No, it's
have
cool.
You had quality time on your own with it yet? I know you're a man to touch his own hair.
It is really nice, but it needs a fiddle, and that's what it hasn't
what
had
would
yet.
We be doing it? If just, I was you... What?
Yeah, just careful, though.
Sorry.
Just little tweaks. Just the little tweaks, sort of, and then it would be just
only
right.
You can do.
Yeah, well, tomorrow morning it'll be lovely.
Okay, what do you think?
Fantastic. My
Thank
God, what a change.
Thank you.
It's good.
Now, are they giving you a style that takes less time to fiddle within the morning or indeed any other time of the day?
Yeah, it's a little bit shorter, so there's a little bit less to try and get my fingers into, so hopefully... it'll merely be a mere 20 minutes.
Right, for everyone at home, and indeed the rest of the country,
if
you don't have homes, I didn't really know I said that. Would you mind just turning to camera two, and we'll just do kind of a before and after. Oh, hello. Hello, someone got out of school early today, didn't they? Loving that work.
Pink shirt's a complimentary thing.
No, I think so. Yeah. I like it. Okay, so, now, back to the house. While you were in the house, you talked about who you'd invite to your dream dinner party. Do you remember your choices of guests?
Yeah, I think there are a number of friends of mine and Ian Wright.
Right, here's a little reminder.
Which five people would you invite round for a dinner party?
It would have to be my mate Nick, my other mate Nick, my mate Alan. How many is that? Three. My mate Houts, who I've known for ages. And Ian Wright because he's Ian Wright. And he's a legend.
Of course, now, obviously, the one thing me and you have in common, probably the only one thing me and you have in common.
You're a gooner.
Yes, I'm a massive gooner.
Didn't
yes.
That. Top draw.
Back,
like that.
Back
yeah.
At ya. Okay, now, do you remember that day at all?
Vaguely, yeah. Mm-hmm. One of the many.
Do you remember this day, which I believe was day 47? Take a look.
When he's, you know Steve Martin, he was brilliant, Man in Two Brains. And he goes, hey, Steve. And Steve goes, Steve, BBC. And Steve goes, Steve Martin, straight away goes, he tries to make a joke, and it's. And he goes, hey, aren't you the BBC no commercial guy? And he looks at me and went, Steve, my question is, why are you funny anymore?
And he's... That day there, obviously, yeah, you're looking at that in the same way I did in rehearsal. PJ making no sense whatsoever.
Dennis Pennis, I think it was.
Oh, was it Dennis Pennis? Yeah, okay, yeah. Right. Now, do you remember that day? I mean, did anything seem strange about that day?
No, not.
Didn't feel a presence at all?
Not majorly, no.
Well, never mind you being the man in the mirror. Take a look at this.
Tim. How you doing? Tim, talk to me, man. You've done a great job. It was nice, it was nice when you said you'd like to have dinner with me because I was very upset that he was an Arsenal man. You had a Bergkamp shirt on. But I love him as well. But you've done great. You came in at a late stage. I think you've done pretty well. And it doesn't matter even if you are ginger.
Oh, I've got to say.
Behind camera 50, actually working on camera 52 that day, just came in to help us out. We were short-staffed. Lovely, the Mr. Ian Wright. Have you met Ian Wright?
Oh, yes, I have, yeah.
I only met him when he came on here. The man's a god, isn't he?
He is, he's very sexy.
Fantastic. What do you think?
That's properly awesome.
Outside chance, his wife's a massive fan of Big Brother, so... If you don't mind, anything you'd like to say to Mr. Wright on camera?
Just repeat what I said. No, you know, he's a legend. God, that was proper emotional.
Brilliant.
Thanks.
The man's emotional.
Yeah,
I'm feeling a lot of love right now in this room. Let's capitalise on that in the full wonderful minutes of the commercial break. We'll see you in a minute. Welcome back to Big Brother's Little Brother. Can you only see when you go like this? I don't know, the camera's just there, so I thought. Time for our final producer chat. She's pretty and she's intelligent to boot. Hello, Deborah.
Hello, Dermot.
How are you? Okay, very they've well. Made it through to the final week. Given £400 worth of shopping, presumably that's a happy house right now.
They're very happy, actually. They are still quite low-key, but I think they're kind of building up slowly.
There's a lot of paranoia, isn't there?
Yeah, I think, as you said... Yes, you did say in the news, quite rightly. They've been thinking that someone's going tonight. They've been peering out the front door. They've been standing on the pool trying to get a look at the scaffolding that's going up for Friday. They obviously don't have a clue that they're all there for a while yet.
When they do things like that, and if they go up to the front door, do you tell them to go back?
We don't, unless they kind of deliberately attempt to communicate. If they were to stand on the swimming pool and shout at perhaps the people putting the scaffolding up, then we'd call them. If they're trying to build some kind of structure, we'd tell them to get down. We'd call them and tell them to stop doing it.
Cool. So how are they getting with this seaside task?
They love it, actually. Well, yeah, they do. I think they secretly quite like it. Jade is a bit concerned. She's doing ventriloquism. She can't really get her B's right. So she's come in and said if she could not say Big Brother, that would be helpful. So we've
obviously... quite difficult,
yeah,
isn't it?
But it's kind of up to her what she says, so that's fine. She also can't decide on a name for the little fella. And
you see live plate spinning now, I gather.
Really? She's quite good, actually. Kate's quite good. She's shown herself to be a bit of an impresario of the spinning. And Alex is very good on the accordion. I think perhaps that's a little special skill he forgot to tell us about. But
and
he is
Johnny
very good.
Johnny playing with his ring right now as well. So what did I get? They win.
They get a very special beach party on Wednesday. I'm not going to divulge the full extent of it, but it will be a day event and it will be a beach party theme.
Will it be like a day out? Will it be a day trip or they've got to stay
day
in the house?
Day trip would strictly be against the rules, okay. Unfortunately. Save that for Friday.
Sorry, residents of Clacton. Could be coming your way. Yes. Debbie, thank you very much. You're okay, welcome. So we are nearing the end, but fear not, even after the last housemate had gone, Big Brother's Little Brother will still be here weeks. We won't be doing anything, we'll just be here. We'll be bringing you this on Sunday. Take a look.
On Sunday, the 20th of July, Little Brother will be coming live from inside the most famous house in Britain. The housemates reunited, celebrity guests and exclusive gossip about what really went on. BBLB, first in, last out.
All right, so we are in the home stretch. It's time to find out who is doing all they can to walk away with 70 grand. Here to talk us through that is BBLB body language expert Susan Quilliam and supporters of each of our four finalists. Johnny's dad, John. Hello, John.
Hiya.
Jay's mother, Jackie. Hello.
Hello, Dan.
Kate's dad, Des.
Hello, Dan.
And one of Alex's friends, Frederick, otherwise known as French Freddy. Hello.
Hello.
Okay, brilliant. Susan, we'll start off with you. As we enter the last week, have you noticed any attitudes changing which would hint towards the housemates? Going for it, going for gold.
I think people have actually relaxed
It's smaller groups, so they're not fighting as much. The end is in sight, and they know that one way or the other, by this time next week, the stress will be off. So actually, they're bonding more, and they're less likely to go for each other as maybe they have in the past.
All right, this is what they said about all that before they went in the house. Take a look.
I would like to go all the way, obviously, because the further you get, the more of your personality people are going to see, the more people are going to get to know you.
I really don't know how many weeks I'd last in the house. I mean, I'd like to think I could last all the weeks.
Being realistically, not I'm going to win. I think I would be number three or number four.
Eviction is going to be... I'll probably cry. I'll be the first to admit that. I'll probably be upset, because I want to get to the end like everybody.
Dej should be very proud. Do you think Kate's in there to win it, or is she just in there to have a good time?
I think she went in there not really believing she could win 70 grand and win the thing. Although she did say at the beginning that, you know, I'd like to be the first girl to win 70,000. Mm-hmm. I don't really think she went in there actually believing she'd get this far.
Of course, her twin, Karen, actually applied, she or did. Wanted to apply. And, right.
Yeah. And then, you're lucky she never got in.
The two of them together, can you imagine that? Okay, well, what about the rest of you? Who out of you can say that their friends or family has got their eyes firmly on the cash, or is it all the experience?
Come on, Johnny's got his money, his eyes on the cash.
You reckon?
Yeah, he's playing the game wicked.
What do you reckon there, John?
Yeah. Oh, I don't agree, honestly.
Johnny's the best.
I know he's not. Yeah, I know he didn't enter the thing for the cash, but obviously the further he's getting, the more confident he's becoming.
I suppose, as well as that, it's the most natural thing in the world. Is to think, you know, I'm a week away from 70,000.
Yeah, that's right.
That's, you know, you can't blame him for thinking that. Susan, from the public's point of view, who's the most naturally appealing as a winner at the moment, and why?
I can't track it down to just one. It's Kate and Alex.
Why so?
Because the voting audience is largely young. They're both attractive. They've got personality. Yeah. And, you know, Kate in particular has got a perfect motivation strategy. She wants it, and she's scared of not getting it.
Well, I mean, the strange thing is that everyone says that always, you know, Big Brother's never won by a woman, et cetera, et cetera. Mm. The amount of people I meet, women especially, who say that Kate's really grown on them in the last couple of weeks.
Yeah.
Okay, Frederick, do you think Alex is in with a good chance?
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. He has been a roller coaster for him since the beginning, but now I think he's in the groove, you know. He finds himself very well. He's himself now. He was not the first week, but now he's himself.
You're obviously from Hornchurch in Essex.
Of course, yes.
I can pick it up here. You're almost identical to Mr. Sibley himself. I mean, how do you know him? Is he an old friend from modelling days?
Yeah, in Tokyo. We met in Tokyo 4 years ago. Okay. With Tim, too. We met Tim, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
So what about the rest of you? Is there anyone you would admit, Jackie has already said, Johnny, that you think that other than the person you're here to support, he's in with a very good chance? Who do you think else is?
I think Kate's in with a very good chance.
Yeah. What about you there, Dad?
Well, I think it's going to be close all round. I think Johnny has probably got a good chance.
Frederick?
Alex.
I'm not allowed to say that, Frederick.
Sorry.
Susan, what do you think?
I think Kate.
You reckon?
Yeah,
okay.
Reckon.
So, right. Very briefly, people, we're just going to give you an opportunity to tell the nation why they think they should be voting for your loved one to win. Not you. I'm sure you have loved ones, but no one's in the
house.
Yeah,
but they're not in the house.
John first to camera two, if you would.
Well, it's too late in the day for me to try and talk anybody into voting for him. You've all seen Johnny. You know what he's like. He's a good lad. He's being honest. He is not playing to the camera. What you see is what you get.
Nah, that's like Alex Ferguson, I like that. You're reverse psychology. Jack.
Vote for what you get.
Hi. Jay's just gone in the ass, made friends, forgot about the cameras, and she's entitled to him because I think she's done the entertainment in there.
Lovely. Des?
Well, I think that... being as this is a game show, and probably Marquette has answered the most questions right, and probably got most of the tasks right, there's the winner.
Interesting. Okay, Frederick.
Alex is genuine, he's funny, and he's got a heart of gold. So,
just for women at home, do you want to elaborate on that? Just talk more in that accent.
What do you mean?
From my mum's watching right now, going, really, Frederick? What else do you want to sell me? Guys, thank you very much. All right, throughout the show, we've been asking you to call in and tell us who do you think is going to walk away with £70,000 and why. I'm sure the guys would like to chip in as well. We should have Robert from Birmingham first on the line. Hello, Robert.
Good evening, Dermot.
You well?
And hello to you all there.
Thank you, Robert. Go for it.
OK, I think Jade will win, Dermot.
Jade?
Yes, she's made mistakes, but she's learned from them. For example, with Sophie, she's learned from them, and she's going from strength to strength. She's open, honest, entertaining, and I seriously believe, she's the show's biggest personality. Mm-hmm. The other three expect to win. Jade doesn't, and I think this could well work in her favour.
Do you think, knowing her as you do, she expected to be out so much more before this? I mean... in the first week, she was up against Lynn.
Yeah, but she didn't. I don't think she was expected to come out the first week, but no longer in 3 weeks. Mm. She is the same as me, excited as much as... I don't know what the word is. Don't help me out.
You thought she was going to come out? You expected it? The expectation was there?
Yeah, the excitement of her staying here has made her think more of hushing up a little bit and communicating with a bit more and then speaking over people more. She's relaxed a bit more in
confidence
the house.
Confidence, as it were, yeah. I mean,
she's
do you think she's growing up in the house?
No.
Brilliant. All right, thank you very much, Robert. Emma next. Hello, Emma.
Hello.
You well?
Yes, I'm fine, thank you.
Go for it.
Well, I think Alex should win it because he's so sexy. And when I saw him dancing behind the door, I just wish that I was playing Follow the Van with him.
Emma, this isn't some sleazy strip show we're talking about. We're going to make a TV show here, Emma.
And I just find him so amusing, especially when he was asking Jay to kiss his butt.
To do his what? Oh, yeah, no, I got it the first time, sorry. No need to repeat it. Thank you very much, Emma. Is he always like that? Is he kind of the life and soul of the party?
He likes, he likes to be like that. But it's funny because seeing on the television, it's different. You see more, even more funny, it's like expanding the character, the personality. Mm-hmm. So it's, I don't know, it's different to see them in real life and on TV.
Sure, brilliant. Okay, Roy from Manchester. Hello, Roy.
Good evening.
Go for it.
Yeah, I think Kate will win it. I think she's the one who's entertained everybody, and I think actually she's kept all the group together. She's absolutely brilliant, and I think she's been absolutely genuine with everything she's said.
Des, have you seen her confidence skyrocket in the last... I mean, she seems to be a confident girl anyway.
I think 2 weeks ago, she really... Yeah, just when the comedy side of it really started. Mm. That was the best week for me, you know. The impersonation of Alex and the...
Brilliant.
The... what was it she did? She...
We're having a barbecue!
Proposed to Adele, didn't she?
Yeah.
Lovely. That was Alex.
Wow.
That was great.
Okay, and Debbie from Hastings, probably her last caller. Hello, Debbie.
Hello.
Go for it.
Hello. Well, I want Johnny to win.
Right.
Because despite what people say about him playing to the cameras, I don't think he'd be able to keep that up all that time. Mm. And if ever there's been any confrontations, he never seems to be dragged into it. Always keeps level-headed, and he's only a fireman, and so he deserves every penny.
Okay, thank you. Oh, nice touch. Thank you very much. Bit of social realism in there as well, Debbie. Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure speaking to all of you. Thank you. Thank you, Susan. Pretty much all we've got time for today. We'll leave you with some live streaming from the house. We'll see you tomorrow at 7 o'clock, E4, with Emma B as our guest. See you then. Take care. Bye-bye.